just hours from now, a large crowd is expected as President Trump holds a diplomatic signing ceremony on the White House lawn. White House officials say they are not requiring those who attend, however, to wear a mask. It's become part of a pattern, of course.
Our John Harwood joins us now from the White House. It is a big day there in terms of this peace agreement signing. It also comes on the same day as we hear more from the president's interview with Bob Woodward.
Poppy, this is a striking rollout of the Woodward book, and we're getting it in stages. Two of the things that we have seen consistently displayed by the president, both by what we've seen with our own eyes and also the accounts of close family members and top aides, two traits consistently: dishonesty and almost exclusive concern for self. Earlier revelations from Woodward show that the president knew that the coronavirus was five times as deadly as the flu when he was telling people publicly it was like the flu. Now we have this clip from April from the president, which was played last night on Stephen Colbert, and it shows the president's own concern about the transmissibility of this virus.
And Bob, it's so easily transmissible, you wouldn't even believe it.
I know.
I mean, you can be in the room. I was in the White House a couple of days ago, a meeting of 10 people in the Oval Office, and a guy sneezed innocently, not a horrible, you know,
yes,
just a sneeze. The entire room bailed out, okay, including me, by the way.
Now, this came as the president was publicly pressuring governors, Democratic governors in particular, to open their states. In June, the president held his first indoor rally in Tulsa. A bunch of his Secret Service agents and advanced staffers got sick. One of his top supporters, Herman Cain, died after that. The president continues to engage in that behavior with the rallies that we've seen in the last couple of days. And the reason for that is he wants to stoke this culture war and portray Democrats and the public health officials as the science nerds who would hurt the economy, and his supporters as the tough guys who would reopen the country, get the economy going. But what we've seen from this private clip is the president himself is not one of those tough guys. He's very concerned about his own safety.
Yeah. It's a consistent thing, right, John? I mean, you see, for instance, that event yesterday, the crowd had no social distancing. The president at a great distance from the crowd, much like you see in the White House, frequent testing, contact tracing, all the kinds of things we don't have nationally as a country.
Exactly. And the president said so. He gave an interview with the Nevada Reporter and was asked, are you concerned about catching the coronavirus? And he said, first of all, well, I'm a little concerned about how close you are to me. Maybe he was joking, but he then alluded to his distance from the crowd. The crowd's not distant from each other, but the president's distance from them.